Hey, what's up guys? This video is going to be big rescue for Windows 11 and Windows 10 users who are signed in with a Microsoft account and forgotten their sign-in PIN or password. You have tried to reset your PIN, you even tried to access and change Microsoft account password, but you don't have access to that email or phone, and you are locked out of your own computer. You are anxious and you don't know how to access your computer without losing your personal information. Stay tuned. In this video, I will show you how to create a local administrator account and use it to access all your data from the locked out computer. My name is Mazhar, and at Rightsolutions, I create tutorial for all you DIY people. If you're new to my channel, please don't forget to subscribe and press the bell icon to get the notification for my next video. Now, without any further ado, let's get to this video. In order to create a local administrator account, we need to open command prompt within Windows recovery environment. The method I'm using in this chapter will be common and may apply for most of the Windows 11 and 10 users. But before that, if you have not already done so, let's try to access Microsoft account and reset your PIN one last time. It may work. So click on I forgot my PIN, and it should bring you this Microsoft account pop-up where you can just enter your password. And if your password is correct, it should work. And if it is not correct, it will show you this incorrect password message. Here you can just go and click on reset now, and you will be presented with the verification pop-up here. In another scenario, if your password is correct, it will also present you a very similar screen again for the verification. Click on show more verification methods to see what method you prefer to receive your code, and I will go with the email. So just click on it, and it will send you the code to this email, and let me retrieve my code here. And here is the code I got with me. So I'm just entering here. So let's go click on verify. And here you get some information warning, but you can read it. But I will just go and click on continue. And here is the pop-up where you can just change your PIN. Add your PIN here and then just verify the PIN again. And now just click on OK. And it will take a while to just prepare your account, just to refresh it. And if everything goes well, you are into the Windows system now. And if it did not work, let's go back to the locked Windows here and start into the recovery environment. On your lock screen, come down here to the power button here. But before clicking on it, just press and hold the shift key on your keyboard, and then you click on this power button. And after you see this options here, so just click on restart. Windows will shut down and restart again, but you don't let your shift key go. Wait till you see a blue screen with the recovery environment. I will fast forward the restarting process, and now you can release the shift key. Now click here on troubleshoot, and in this next window, just click on advanced options, and here is the command prompt. So just click on it to launch the command prompt. If you have succeeded to open the command prompt, then you can skip chapter 2 and move on to chapter 3. And for those who has encountered errors, some kind of errors, can continue with chapter 2. In this chapter, I will show you how to access command prompt if you have some exceptional privacy or configuration issues. You can pause this video to see the highlights of this chapter. Before continuing to this video, if you have faced this BitLocker recovery key error and you have lost the recovery key, this drive cannot be unlocked by any other means unless you really find your key and unlock this drive. Otherwise, reinstalling Windows is the only option to get this PC to work. And that means you will lose all your personal data and configuration and all the software you installed on this encrypted hard drive. Other than BitLocker encryption, you could face a lot of other errors like recovery options are missing in your system, or maybe command prompt is asking for admin password. And there may be some other scenarios too. For all these scenarios, you need to create a bootable media. A USB flash drive about 8 gigs of capacity, a little more, will be good, sufficient enough to create that media. And this bootable media can be created by any working PC or by Windows Media Creation Tool. I would prefer a Windows Media Creation Tool. And for that, let's head to the browser. And in the search bar, type here Windows Media Creation Tool, and just hit enter. And you will see this, most probably the first option will come here from Microsoft support window. So just click on it here. And in this window, you can see there are a lot of options for you, Windows 7, 8, 10, or 11. I prefer going with the latest Windows, which is Windows 11. So just click on it. And here in this window, you can see there are three options. First is Windows Installation Assistance, and then second one is Create Windows 11 Installation Media. So just click on this download here. And the file has started to download, and my McAfee also seen that it's already downloaded. So just open this folder here and double click to open this file here, and provide this permission and accept the license terms. And on this screen, you can change the language if you want. I'll keep United States English. and the rest of it you can just leave as it is. And now then you can click on next, and on this screen you can select a USB flash drive and insert your 8 gig USB into your USB port, and then click on next. This page, you can see refresh this list of the devices attached to your computer, and make sure that you have selected the correct one here, and then click on next. And now it will start downloading the file from the Windows server. It's a little more than 5 gigs of file. It might will take a little while. I will fast forward this video till the download is complete, and don't forget, it is writing it to your USB, so it might be slower. Bootable USB flash drive is ready, so click on finish, and we are done with this browser window too. Insert this USB into one of the ports of your computer, and remember, to boot from USB, you may need to change boot order in the BIOS settings. But most manufacturers has a preset hotkey or boot menu option key. So when a computer is starting up, press the appropriate key to access the boot menu. This key varies from computer to computer. I have collected a bunch of popular brands keys for your convenience. So make sure you know what key is for your computer. Now start your computer and press the hotkey, and you will be presented with the boot selection menu here. So you should know what is your hard drive. So mine is Samsung SSD 99, and the other one, which is a USB, is it says enter setup. So just use your arrow keys to come to this enter setup and hit enter. Windows installation will start from your USB, and very soon you will be presented with this dialog box. So click on next here, and on this next page, we're not installing the Windows, so don't click on install. So just at the bottom, you can see that it says repair this computer. So just come and click on this button, and it will bring up this menu for you. And this is basically the troubleshoot menu, which what we were actually looking for. So just click on troubleshoot, and from here, just go down and just look into the command prompt and just click on it. And now your command prompt is launched. So we can continue to the next chapter now. In this chapter, we'll modify some registry keys and then restart this computer into that modified command prompt. And then we'll add one guest user who can log into this PC without using any password, in case you have to give your computer to somebody else. And then after that, we'll be adding the local administrator who will have the full access to the all the locked and all the user accounts. And then I'll show you to sign in with the local admin account, and it'll show you how you can access your data with the locked accounts. But before you proceed, a few words of caution. Proceed only if you understand the potential impact, because improper changes to the registry can cause significant issues. So I always suggest to take a backup of your registry before you proceed with this. So now if you're ready, so just come on this command prompt, click here, and then type regedit, and hit enter. This will open up this registry editor. So come here on click on H key local machine, and then go to file, and then click on load hive. So in this new window, you have two points of navigation here. You can just click on this PC, or you can just go through this up arrow here. So we'll just go and click this up arrow. Click it once, it will load the Windows directory, and click one more time, it will bring you your boot drive. Click one more time, and it will bring you to this PC menu, and you can see all the drives which are connected in your PC. Now we need to find on which drive our system is installed. So let's start from the bottom one. So drive X, which is the virtual drive and created for boot only. And then you can see the second one, which is about 800 MBs, and that cannot be the main hard drive. And the third one, which is about 100 MBs, it says system reserved. This also cannot be the main hard disk. And if you look at this disk D, which is about 63 gigabytes, I created this partition just to install this Windows for this video. So this is my main drive. So if you know the size of your hard disk, it's very easy to find out, and double click to open that hard drive, and then open Windows folder here. Double click on it, and now look for a folder system32, and double click to open this folder again, and now look for folder config, and double click to open this folder as well. And in this folder, look for a file called system. Double click to open this file here, and then name this file. I'm going to use this digits 112233, so it will appear on the top. So name does not matter, but I will keep this digit so I can easily find this file. So just click OK. Now come to this H key local machine directory again, and click on this small arrow to open this directory. Here you will see our newly created directory 112233. So click on this small arrow to open this directory again, and then in this directory, look for folders called setup. Click on it, and on the right side pane, you will see there are a lot of files. So just look for a file called command line. Double click to open it and add a value cmd.exe and then click OK. In the same window, now look for file setup type. Double click to open it and add a value there 2 and then click OK. And now come to the left side pane and close this directory 112233 and then go to file and click on unload hive and then say yes. And then here we're done with the registry editor. So you can just close this registry editor here and just type exit on this command prompt and hit enter. Now you're back to the recovery environment. So click here on continue, exit and continue to Windows 11. It will restart, but instead of starting Windows, it will start this newly created command prompt, which we just created. You can see I run into this blue screen here, which says your device run into problem and needs to restart. We will restart for you. You are possibly will not have this problem, but even if you have it, so just let it go. It will restart Windows in the command prompt. So just wait. Here you can see that my command prompt I had already loaded. So now before we add any other account, let's find out how many existing accounts we have on the system. So for that, just type here net space user and hit enter. And here we got two accounts. The first account is a predefined account, which is default account. And the second account is my Microsoft sign-in account, which is actually locked now. Okay, so let's go and add some users here. So I will create two user accounts. I will create a first user as a regular guest user who can get into your system without using password. You can skip this one if you don't want to. And the second one, I will create a local administrator with the full access to all the user accounts. So click on this blinking cursor here and type net space user space. And here you can put the name of your choice, whatever you want. I will put max1122, give a space, forward slash add and hit enter. And here you can say it's a command completed successfully. So one user is created. So let's create the second user with the password. So type here net space user and then give a name here. So I'll give max2 and then give a space and put the password here, whatever you want. So I will put 1122 and then give a space and forward slash add and hit enter. And it says the command completed successfully. So the second user also has been added. So now let's add the second user to the local administrators group. So come to the prompt again and type here net space local group space administrators space and the username, which is max2 and space forward slash add and hit enter. And it says the command completed successfully. We are done. Type exit and hit enter. So these are the all accounts on this system here. So the first one account, which is locked account, my Microsoft sign-in account. And the second one is the guest account, which we just created. And the third one, the local administrator account. So just click on this account to log in here. And now key in the password, what we have. So you know that 1122. So just click on enter here. And it will prepare your account. Right now, it will just setting up all these configurations for the new user. So just bear with it. It might will ask you some questions, so you just answer it. And here, it's a temporary setup, so you can just say no or yes, whatever you feel that you want to do it. I select no and accept. And here also, I will say no and accept again. And I can just say required only and say accept. And we're almost done here. So just say no and accept and just say no and accept. And here we are. So you can just see that we had already entered into the system here. Click on the username here and it says local account and you can see max local account. Close this. You can switch a user from here also. But let's go right click on the start menu and just go click on settings. And now from settings here, just go on to this accounts, click on it. And here you can just see it says max2 local account administrator. So now you have full rights on the system, all the accounts, whatever you have here on the system, you can just access all the data from these folders. And now to find the data of your locked account, just open the Windows Explorer. And from here, you can just click on to this PC. And from here, just to open up this C drive. And go and click on users and from users select this Max, which was my Microsoft account. So just double click on it. It will ask you for permission. So just click on it Just say continue, because you are already administrator, so you can open all the accounts here. So here it is. So now all these default folders where your data is actually hidden. So if you double click on this desktop, it will open up the desktop, all the data on this, documents and downloads, your pictures, your videos, and all whatever the data you think that it's important for you, you can just copy them on USB, or possibly you can just copy them from here and put it into your profile. Or maybe you can just simply copy it to the desktop. It will be available for you. But you have the full access. You can operate all the softwares, whatever the softwares are in the system here. And later you can decide what to do with the locked account. You can keep it as it is and see if you remember the password or you find the password. Or maybe you can just delete that user if you want. Or even after retrieving your data, you can just completely fresh reinstall your system. So up to you, whatever you want to do with it. So this was for the administrator account. If you want to see the guest account, so just come to the login screen here and just click on the username, and you will see that it's not asking you any password, and it is just going to configure the new user account. Okay, I will skip this configuration. So here we are in the Windows here. So just right click on this start button again and click on settings and go to this accounts here. Just click on accounts. And here you can just see that it says max 1122 local account. It does not say administrator. So this is what, this is a guest user. You can just give this computer to anybody. He cannot access your personal data on any locked or maybe on administrator account. And even if a user try to access that locked folders, so it will ask you the password for the administrator, and this password will be for this local administrator which we just created.
And that's it for this video, guys. If you think this video given you any help or given you any value, please give it a thumbs up, and I will see you with the next video. You have a wonderful day.